Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about how we can load related data using Entity Framework Core. There are three ways you can load data. One is ego loading, second is explicit loading, and the third is lazy loading. Ego loading is not the most efficient way of loading the data, but it's the most easiest way of loading the data. I'm going to be using the same database that I've been using for my previous demos. And at this point, it doesn't really matter if you're doing the database first approach or code first approach, or it doesn't really matter which database engine you're using. If you're using correct database provider and connection string, you should be good here. All right, so for my demo, I had created this ASP.NET web API, and then I was pulling the publishers. In my browser in JSON format here. But you can see that this publisher has users and books associated with this table. If I look at the JSON, you can see there's books and users field, which are empty because we are not putting any inner join on a publisher to pull the related data associated with publishers. Okay, so how do we do that? The very first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this function because in my function, I want to include more details for the publisher. I'm going to say get publisher details, and I'm going to change the URL of this API so that it goes to the correct function to get more details of the publisher. Okay, so the very first thing that we need to do, we need to make sure that we are pulling the correct publisher. This find async pulls the correct publisher, but we won't be able to put our inner joins here. So I'm gonna get rid of this find async, and I'm gonna say put a where condition here instead, and say that pull publisher ID. equal to ID which has been passed in the URL, and pull first and default. Sweet. I'm gonna get rid of this await keyword because it doesn't, the where condition doesn't return. It's not an async function. All right, so let's run this and see if this works. I'm gonna put it in the launch setting so that it goes to that particular URL. So it's going to get publisher's detail and the first publisher, and now it's pulling the publisher ID 1, and books and users are still empty because we haven't loaded them yet. All right, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna say publisher should include, their books into the results too. So this is how you write it. This is how you include, this is how you put an inner join saying that publishers have books associated it. So please include when you're loading, this is an ego loading. So this, when you're loading the URL, when you're loading the results, please include books into publishers too. Let's run this and see if this. We're gonna get an exception here, and it's a JSON exception. If you're using ASP.NET Web API Core 3 or more, anything more than that, you will get this exception because what it's saying that a possible object cycle was detected, which is not supported, and or if the object depth is larger than maximum allowed depth 32. So .NET Core has changed its policies how they handle JSON. So we'll have to ignore this looping in JSON in order to fix this problem. And so the very first thing that I'm gonna do, I'm going to go and install ASP.NET Core MVC Newton Soft JSON. And then I'm gonna install 3.1 because that's the latest. But if you'll have to change properties of your project to at least 3.1 if you're installing anything 3.1 related. So I'm gonna install this package. And I'm going to use something from this package in my startup class. I'm gonna copy some code from this notepad. I'm gonna paste this code in the video description so that you can get access it too. So what I'm trying to tell my services here when they start up is to ignore the reference looping. If you ignore that reference looping, then we won't get that exception when we try to show a JSON which has related data into it. Okay, now let's run this and see how that works. So when I run it now, you can see that we're not getting any exception anymore. And publisher loaded books related to it. So this publisher has two books, book one and book two, which is associated. And it loaded other details associated with the book two. We did not have to tell which columns to load for this object. So you just have to include book and which will load all the information associated with that publisher. Okay, so if I go to my users are still empty. So let's try and add users. So if I look at my diagram here, you can see that I had publishers and I loaded books related to the publisher. And now I want to load users related to my publisher. To do that, I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna say that as you included books, let's include users associated. The employees who are working for this publisher should get loaded in the same results too. And the same results too. Sweet. So I'm gonna run it and see if my users are getting loaded in my results. So you can see books are getting loaded, and now users are also getting loaded for the publisher. And you can it so it shows the number of items in it too, which is like JSON extension for my Chrome. But you can see there are two books and there are 10 users who are working for this publisher now. Okay. So I want to go one step deeper now. I want to show, now I showed books related to the publisher, users related to the publisher. I want to show the jobs related to the users who are working for the publisher, and I want to show the sales related to the books for the same publisher. So how do we do that? To do that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to, if you write then include, I'm gonna hit a tab here and say then include, which will be like inner join for the inner join that you applied for the publisher. So what it's trying to do, it's trying to go in one step deeper into the query and pull information related to the related table to the publisher. So I'm gonna say book, and book has sales, so please load sales for the books. And my user has some jobs. This is a one-to-one relationship. One user can have only one job. So I'm gonna say job. I'm gonna say job, and that should load job related to the user, and this will load sales related to the books. Sweet. Let's run this and see if this works. So if I run it, you can see that the books now has sales. So this publisher released this book, which has sales, and it's been sold two times. And there is another book which has the same sales. This book has been sold only once. And this user has only one job because it's one-to-one relationship. And you can see that this job is marketing manager for this user, and the other user has designer job. So you can see that I went one step deeper, and you can go another step deeper to find out which store the sales have happened. So if you include one more then include here, then you can see then include after this, then you will be able to find out information about stores too. So this is how you can load related information in using Entity Framework Core, and you don't have to learn any of the SQL syntax for different database that you're using. If you know Entity Framework Core and you know how to load related data, you should be good. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me on Twitter or Facebook. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.